Yeah, I'm not in the project. I'm not the. We have what you call the PMC, Project Management PMC, Project Management Committee, that is constituted, that is now mandated to monitor. Me, I'm only as the patron of to oversee. So what you should be asking or you should be telling people.
So you're overseeing the biggest project in your constituency, but you don't know what project it is, yes. And you don't know who is running the project. Are you being for real right now, Peter Salasian? You are peddling, bro.
I've told you, number one, that the project is being done, which is now on the ground being happening. It's now taking place. Now for you to start asking me who is doing what is doing, you know, now that one is now missing the point. What now you guys you should be asking is, if there is anyone who complain that there is money that's ilifanywa nini, ama pesa CDF ilipotea, that is the point that you people should be asking. And that is how tomorrow you are going to be misled tomorrow here. In fact, you should be telling us, you should be asking me, now where come a CDF, ama Mumias East CDF, for the first two years, what have you done? What have you achieved? And then I'll be answering you A, B, C, D. But now somebody coming up and saying, oh, anachukua kickback, anachukua pick. Who has come and complained that Peter Salasi is taking kickbacks? And who
to has... Tuambia mtu atuambia jina yo project, basi. Wacha ni mambia niambia jina project. Kama wewe utaniambia. Wanasema you didn't even advertise the tender. Is it true?
For you. We go...
Network yako ni mbaya mzee na uko na airtime allowance ya 15 G's my friend. Network yako ni mbaya tu.
Haya, nilikuwa nimepotea. Nilikuwa napotea. Unajua watu wanapiga simu yangu. Haya, ask another question.
Wacha tu tusimamie hapa kwanza before tuende mbali. Tutana ngoja. Yeah. Just I want to tell you this. I want to give the people on the mic a minute to ask a question starting with my co-host. But before I go there, nataka tu nikuambie kitu moja Peter Salasia, and I want to send you on behalf of the other 300 MPs. Sawa. Unaona vile nimekuuliza swali moja umetembea kutoka hapa mpaka Lodwar ukirudi. That is why watu wanawachomea nyumba. Kwa sababu gani? You are not open. You are not transparent. You need to tell us. Unajua mtu akikwambia there is a 50 million project. Mimi hata project ya 5,000. Ni sahihi najaribu kujenga studio yangu. Ninajua vizuri nahitaji 10,000. Nikitaka sahihi sponsors waniletee 10,000, hiyo project na I manage. So wewe kama custodian wa Mumias East, it is very wrong. And I want when you get off this space to call your CDF chairman. Akuambie ni nini inaendelea huko. Yeah.
Before you continue on that note. First of all, we should be very much objective. You know, when we start now going petty issues, right now... You
CDF is not a petty issue. It was raised by Kenyans.
No,
come on, Peter.
No, I'm just saying this. You should be asking me, there is this person who came and did this and this and this and this. What is your point? Amai project will he launch? In Amai project is a shoddy project. Amai project... Lakini sasa kuniuliza, like, for example, which company? That is, those are non-issue. We should be going on the real issue. Like, kuniambia hii project uliweka hii pesa fulani, hii project has never started. Na hii project hii, by the way, the one wanasema, sahi we started it like about 4 months ago. And 4 months ago, you go there, we are almost done in the next, and we give them 52 weeks. They should be done with the project. And that is what exactly I'm following. Hivi lingine hii tukianza kusema, oh, hii kampuni inaitwa nini? Hiyo kampuni inaitwa nini?
Is it a KMTC? Is it a KMTC?
Yes, it is a KMTC.
Sasa
yes,
ni ngumu kusema hivyo. Sisi ni watu wazima. Mpaka niambiwe kwa comment section ndio ukubali. Come on, bro.
Hiyo ndio KMTC. Come on, KMTC. Sasa uko vizuri.
Sasa si unasema hivyo. People want to hear our projects. Wewe si ndio nimekuambia mnachukiwa kwa sababu ya hii uongo uongo.
Unajua nilikuwa nasikia.
Hakuna mtu anakupiga hapa bro. Na hakuna mtu amekuita hapa kupige vita. Wewe tuambie ukweli, tuambie ndio. Sasa unaona kuna mtu amesema hapa hivi ni KMTC. So it's nice. So Salasia, I want you to conclude on that so that Ayo can ask your question and you go back to hearing other people here, like 2-3 people to ask a question before we let you go. Can you hear him? Amanda. Oh my god.
Yes, aongee.
Ndio yeye amerudi.
Okay, so, good. I appreciate the fact that you're not running away. So let me let Ayo ask you, ukimaliza hiyo point yako, Ayo akuongeleshe. Mimi for now, nataka tu kuambia hii ni home run with people, ladies and gentlemen. Ayo.
Aya. So now, I was saying this. Within this, with this 131 million, within the few short period of time that I've been there, we have been able to do like the KMTC project that you are talking about of 50 million. And this one is a project that is going to make Shanda KMTC to be the biggest KMTC in Western Kenya. And after then, we are also doing another project of 50 million. With that one is the Wanka Technical, which is going to make it the most, the biggest TTI that we're going after Sigalagala in Kakamega County. So we have a lot of projects we have done with the CDF with a lot of transparency. Mambo ya bursary. I give bursaries to the students. And so when somebody comes and tells that pesa ya CDF inakuwa mismanaged, when you go to my constituents, every school, like the toilets, the schools have been being closed because of lack of toilets. I've brought a new modern building ablution blocks that now we are solving the problem of able to do 30 around almost 35 of them in my constituents. And you find like right now there will be no any day that I'll be called that Choi Mesink. Arjo imefanya nini, courtesy of. Lakini sasa see that because nimeweka pale 2,000, I only put that we cannot continue stressing Kenyans with the pay slips. We have other avenues. And pesa inapotolewa upande wa budget. Wanaweka pesa kwa budget zambazo, they are not making sense. Like tuko na kitu ya BRT. Hii ya BRT iliwekewa pesa in 2020 from 2020 mpaka saizi. Hii atika super highway. Almost like 10 billion, but when you ask, where has this money, because Ukenda Pale, there's nothing that is happening. Those are the questions that you should be telling people. Number one, another thing you should be asking tomorrow, you should ask the Muulize Ruto. Muulize President Wenu huyu, kwamba. Yes.
Good evening.
Chebu, kwanza, please.
Yes.
1 minute, you finish that. Yeah, 1 minute submission, Salasi, we go to Ayo, because we also have a couple of people on the line, yeah?
Yes. So tomorrow when he comes, he told us about the issue to do with the Eurobond. You should ask him, with this Eurobond, ambaye anasema, ilichukuliwa 2014, around there, when Njuguna, who is the CS of the finance, anaitua the Ntuge, was the PS of finance, made him to be the governor of Central Bank. So, na ina semekana kwamba that money, a Eurobond, it never touched the hand in Kenya. And about 2 billion dollars. So, Muulize kesho, ya kwamba hii pesa, mbona hao watu wenye walimismanage hii pesa, mukawaleta, how can they account and fail to account for this money, and then again you bring them to be the helm of managing our resources. So those are the questions. Na sisi kama mimi pia niko katika committee ya agriculture, muulize ya kwamba hii maneno hii, sisi kama committee ya agriculture we moved all around to find ya kwamba there was hiyo mambo ya fertilizer, it was a scam. Na mbona ya kwamba, because he should be, the CA should be the one to be given the first hand information, but he didn't have any information. Why did he hold on him? So hiyo ndio mambo ambayo mimi nitauliza, na msikubali ya kwamba wa host, nyinyi ndio mafamu host, ndio mjue nani analeta maswali.
Unajua kwa nini nacheka, Peter? Unajua kwa nini nacheka? Kwa sababu wewe unasema Ruto asiruke maswali na wewe umeruka maswali hapa. Wacha tu Ayo akuulize maswali. Ni kama yangu ni magumu. Wacha Ayo akuulize basi. Ayo muulize swali.
Unajua wewe umeuliza mambo ya company inafanya kazi, lakini kama umeuliza project
na CDF, nimekuuliza CDF ni gani, that is for one, nimekuuliza CDF ni gani, nimekuuliza kwa sababu ni jana kwa bunge nilisikiza wakisema kwamba MPs are using CDF badly, and I really appreciate that you told us that there is a CDF committee.
Yes.
But then again, while we are at it, yes, somebody was here telling us exactly what is happening in your county. And I asked you a very simple question. Do you have a 50 million project? Mimi sitoki Mumias East.
Yes. Okay? Yes, I do have the 50 million
project. Exactly. That is how we want. Na nataka next time ukiulizwa maswali, twende direct. Hizi mambo ya my history ndio zinafanya mna.
Unajua sasa network ilikuwa ina sumbuka kidogo, lakini hiyo ni, and I'm happy that even the people on the ground are able to tell you that ya kwamba ni KMTC project.
Okay.
So that one maybe I'll apologize on that, but when I'll be straight to the point when you ask me a given question.
Ayo, ask Peter Salasi a question. I'm gonna give like 2-3 questions before I go to the next order of business.
Niko na swali. Ayo.
Kidogo tu. Kidogo tu, ngoja, kidogo tu tana. Just a moment. Honorable Salasia, good evening. Can you hear me?
Evening too, how are you?
I am very well.
Yes.
I am very well, but not that well, because our country is going to the drains. But anyway, here's the thing. Mm-hmm. I have a few questions for you. First of all, as a leader, one thing I know about leadership is taking accountability. You have to be able to take accountability. If, I mean, as much as you are leading the people from your constituency, you are a leader to all of us. Sawa. So tukiuliza swali, haimaanishi lazima tukue tunatoka kwako ndio tuulize hiyo swali. We are all Kenyans and Kenya is our business. Aya. My question is, in terms of accountability, history of CDF and all these monies that are being allocated to constituencies, are they getting to the people? And is there an oversight? Is there an oversight that makes sure that these monies that are released, they are not eaten? Like we said, hizi pesa hazikulu zinafikia watu grassroots level. Na kama zinawafikia, how is it helping them? Because I'm sure from your constituency, I'm sure there are students, kuna watoto wenye wameshindwa kujoin form 1 ama wameshindwa kuenda university because hawana school fees. What are you doing? What have you done? And what are other your members of parliament and your fellows doing to ensure that such things don't happen in today's society? Because to be honest, you are our leader. Na sisi ni wadosi wako. Unajua wewe si mdosi wetu. Sisi ndio waheshimiwa kwanza, by the way. Wewe si mheshimiwa. Ni sisi tumekuemploy. Na sisi ndio tunaweza kukutoa kwa hiyo kiti. So sisi kama wenye tumekuemploy, mbona hautaki kukua accountable? Because I had the host asking you questions, but you are running away from taking accountability. And I had you saying or pointing fingers instead of saying whatever I've done is A, B, C and D. Na hapa ndio maneno inaharibika. Mimi nifanya pati yangu, sasa imebaki kwa watu wengine wanafaa kufanya the rest of the job and they're sleeping on the job. Are you able to mention these people that are sleeping on their jobs so that tujue hapa ndio penye vitu zinaenda mrama, if that makes sense?
Peter,
are you there? Are you there, Peter? Peter, going once.
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
This is Home Run with PP.
Did you get the question from Ayo? You got the question from Ayo?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I got it.
Sir, Jibu, in 1 minute, I'll be timing you.
I want to...
All right, thank you so much for this opportunity.
Now, wait, are we there?
Yes, you're there, Honorable.
This fund, this fund has been structured in a way that there is no any loophole whereby the money can be mismanaged. Like on my side, let me just take a very easy way on my side. When it comes to the projects, as I've told you before, that projects have to be approved by the CDF board, which is here in Nairobi. And before even that, and then we also have the audit, the team from the auditor that comes also to counter check and see how that money has been utilized. And then look at like in my constituency, I've been in the office for the last two financial year. In the first financial year I've made it compulsory that 100% transition from primary school to secondary school, whereby we give everybody the bursary to day school. Those are day schools. That one is compulsory. We give 5,000 because after the collapse of Mumia Sugar, there's been a total poverty and there has been a lot of dropouts of children. Though I've made it compulsory. And that one happened last year, and even this year, it has happened. Then number two, we have also decided that because of the issues to do with the primary schools. You can hear?
Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
Yeah. Yes. Our primary schools are a very pathetic situation. And you see, the funds of CDF are meant to coordinate the functions of the national government.
Can I take over?
Yes.
Okay, let me. I've handled that issue. Chebuka seems not to. And kama metuhak, Maliza, yes. 30 seconds. I want to hear from 6,000 kiongozi and Ameris.
Yes. Yes. So I was saying that apart from the bursary that you have been giving out, like for me, I've done my flagship projects. I've bought, like for this year, I've bought the bus for the Wanga Technical. I've bought the I've done the KMTC. I've given them the code, the lab skill. I've done that one. I've done water projects for the three schools. I've done total facelift of renovation of primary schools. Like right now, we have done four of them, the total of them. We have done the terrazos in all. Almost like five schools. We have done the modern ablution block to 35 primary schools. We have done the footbridge. We have done so far. We have done two footbridge, among other many things that we are doing as the CDF. So what I can just conclude by saying is that the CDF is the only fund that can be felt because it doesn't.
Kwani MP ujui dunga na ampatika nangi kwa simu.
MP bwana unaishi wapi hata una internet? Safaricom wana kuumiza hivi. Hata wifi MP. MP bwana. Internet yako ni mbaya bwana MP bwana. Anyway, let me donate the next minutes to whatever. Six please. 6,000. Ask MP a question. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Asante.
Habari ya Salasia.
Mzuri sana.
Unajua mimi I'm not interested in what projects you have done because that is your constituents. What I'm interested in is you are a teacher at Sigalagala, a volunteer teacher earning 13,000. That is before you were elected to office. During your campaigning period, Eugene Wamalwa gave you 100,000 Kenya shillings for your campaign for you to be able to buy. Recently, recently, after you assumed office as a member of parliament, I saw you count 500,000 Kenya shillings on live TikTok and claiming ini pesa kidogo sana. That is my first question. I want you to explain to me as a member of parliament who has a remainder of 2,000 Kenya shillings after all the deductions. How did you come about 500,000 Kenya shillings showing it on live TikTok? Second question. Let me round up all my questions, then you answer all of them. Second question, I understand, and as somebody who has been in this game and interacted with people, I understand that there is no rich man who thinks about the common mwananchi. As an MP affiliated to Azimio, you did not vote no because you wanted you had the interest of the common mwananchi, but you voted no because you were not in the cohort of the people that received 2 million, because a president, a bill must have an opposition, because not all members of parliament cannot vote yes. So kindly clarify the two so that these honorable members who are here can also know.
Salasa, it's your turn.
Salasi, are you there? Hey, Mike, network yako leo, man. Safaricom walijua. Are you there, Salasia?
Yes, I'm here.
Did you hear so the question from 6,000?
Yes.
Okay, nimesikia. Go ahead and respond.
Now, kama it's just a logic. Kama nikiwa nimechukua, for example, nilikuwa nimechukua mortgage yangu ya kununua. So you'll take a loan, for example. You buy whatever, so you can have some ulikuwa umebaki na change. Sasa hiyo pesa ambayo nalipia ni ile pesa ambayo nilikuwa nimechukua loan ambayo sasa lazima pia si una venye nilikuwa nimestate ya kwamba of things that I'm doing at the moment. So if by that time I was having some change, nikaambia ndio hii nimechukua. Lakini sasa saa hii haiko, lakini sasa niko na biashara ambazo at least zinanisaidia kufanya ABCD, at least to move on, napata some fuel na kumove around and also support. And also coming to this point, like in my constituency, I've come up with an empowerment program. Like more in the previous member of parliament has been dishing out 100 shillings. In my leadership, what I've done, I have introduced the creativity in amongst the women. And you go to Mumias East, we produce our own yogurt under my leadership that I did and empowered women. Right now, they are doing and selling the yogurt milk edition. There is the do mats, easy carpets. They are doing it and they're making their own money. I've done kitu inaitwa the shoemaking. They're making the shoes wenyewe. I've done ile ya baking. They do kutengeneza mikate, kutengeneza short cases, whatever. All those things they're doing. So you find like, that's why you find like for me, I don't have a lot of pressure to do that. Then now, let me answer your question why I voted no on that basis. Not because that I was to oppose the president or to make happy the Azimio team. There are key things. Before, the way you've just said that, I used to be a teacher at Galagala where I used to earn 13K a month. And by the way, because of that, what I used to do, after then I used to do what you call the online writing. Then when I was doing the online, there was a time we used to write for articles for a certain company from America. It reached us a point and then they just closed all the accounts from Kenya, for all those people who have the accounts but are from Kenya. So when it reached that point and when I went through the bill,
Germany. Peter. Okay.
I've also done online writing.
Yeah.
I've done online writing my whole years in campus and I've not been this rich. But
alisema ni kampuni ilifungwa.
Anyways,
I was just trying to say to tell you why I voted no. So, and when I raised that issue in the parliament, I remember Kimani Kuria saying that we are only taxing the digital providers. And that is why I asked them that if we are taxing the digital providers, what makes them, because you find like they have a platform. If you are a digital provider, you can decide, like, because there are other taxes that are being given on here. You can decide to work maybe with the youth from Uganda or wherever. So just to tell you that I didn't oppose the bill, not just because that to impress the other side, but I voted with my conscience.
I want to move to the kiongozi amekuwa kijaribu kuuliza swali. Kiongozi, what do you have for Salasia?
Habari zenu wenzangu.
Nzuri sana labda.
I think you don't need to kumsumbua Salasia sana, because uongo mingi imetoka kwake. The swali ni mumeuliza ni project gani inafanyika huko kwake, na anasema hajui. You know the reason why he said hajui ni Peter Salasia is just telling us CDF amepata 131 million. The truth of the matter is Peter Salasia mwene one MP among 300 MPs. Out of 131 million, we are very sure, with the corruption which is going on, hakuna ile 10% ya 10 million kwanza. Hiyo ndio anajisustain nayo. That's why hiyo payslip yake anatuonyesha. Kitu anajisustain nayo, si hiyo biashara ndogo ndogo yenye nasema. ya ukweli ni kwanza na hiyo 10%. And if you go back to hiyo 50 million enye anasema anajenga na KMTC, the reason why hataki kusema hiyo kampuni either ni yake, ama ya ndugu yake, ama ya kazini yake, ama ya mjomba yake, and that project for sure, mtu akienda kuangalia, hata tunaweza mtuma mtu aende Mumias, hiyo project ni yake, na that's why hataki kusema. So hii unafiki kama hii. Enye tuna,
now, bro, I think you have raised a very, I think even in the parliament, if you raise something that touches somebody, touches that personal.
Salase, you have a right of reply right after Kiongozi, exactly. Don't worry. You have a right of reply.
Na okay. Hakuna mbunge atakuambia hii project ina kampuni hii na hii na hii na. And I'm very sure Salasia knows the name of that company. He knows the director. Na yeye ndio labda ana finance. So hakuna mbunge atakuambia this is a societal problem. Waheshimiwa wenye tunawapeleka huko, hiyo project wao wenyewe ndio wafanya. Out of the 131 million yenye anapata, I can assure you, kama si nusu, three quarter inafanyika na Peter Salasia. Si yeye peke yake, ni wabunge wote. Because utaona, Peter Salasia alikampaign na 10,000. Ikifika 2027, you will be seeing Peter Salasia moving with chopper Mumias East. Hiyo pesa itatoka wapi? Inatoka kwa CDF. Not only CDF. Constituency, kuna kitu inaitwa kera. Kuna kura. Kuna electricity. Kuna agriculture. Hizo zote, hizo project, national government, ikipeleka kwa hiyo constituency. Hawa wameteka serikali, national government wamewateka, wao wenyewe ndio wanafanya. So that's why we can't believe Peter Salasia and we can't believe any other politician. Hii unajua anajaribu kutupeleka kwa rais na yeye mwenyewe ako kwa hiyo.
Niko na swali kiongozi. Yeah.
Peter Salasia. Sema
okay,
wacha aulize hiyo swali.
Kama wewe ni mkweli Peter Salasia, ambie hawa 13k followers wenye wako hapa. Hiyo kampuni na unajua inaitwa ni kampuni inaitwa nini? Na directors ni kina nani?
Okay, that is good. I think we also now need to understand the legal framework whereby the MP comes in. The MP is nowhere in particular. By the way, when it comes to the matters to do with the procurement.
That's wrong.
The procurement, and I think...
Peter, Peter. Nikulize, who selects the CDF committee? Who selects the CDF committee?
There is a guideline.
Who selects it?
Yes, there is a guideline. But who selects? Answer the question. Focus on the question.
Let me now explain to you the guideline. Mm-mm. The guideline. Mm-mm. How it comprises.
Skiza, Salasia. Skiza MP. Skiza.
Yes.
Achana like this story mingi. Just answer the question as asked. Who selects the committee? Just pinpoint. Tell us this. It's PP, it's IO, it's 6,000. Ivo. Unagen. Exactly. Usiende story mingi. Atio, nini. There's a attacky guideline. Tuambie tu. Who and who and who. Simple.
First of all, the advert is made, right? The CDF board advertises. The CDF board gives the go-ahead to the fund manager to advertise the vacancies of the committee members. Now, once they advertise, they say in that committee of the seven people, there is in that... so listen, you know people you don't want to learn. In that committee of
one or two, we are learned, Mzee. Usiseme that you don't want to learn. We have read these documents. They are public documents, Peter Salasia. They are public. Now, you are not. Hakuna kitumbi unatufunza hapa. Tuataka tu tuambie. Umesema MPs are not involved. Do you select? Ama mselect?
Yes.
That's what we want to know.
Now,
do you select the CDF committee? Are you involved in the CDF committee?
There is no anywhere where the MP selects any member. There's no anywhere. At all. So, and that is why I was just trying to say that once you apply, once the advert is made from the CDF board gives the custodian, who is the fund manager, to advertise the seven positions. And in this seventh position, one position is being headed by the DCC. DCC, you know the DCC. Then another position, it is for the fund manager, who is the custodian of the CDF from the CDF board. And then now we remain with the five members of the board, Now, in these five members, they give, like, for example, they advertise. People now bring in the application. There is called male representative, the female representative, the youth representative for male representative. Then it's per ward. So they select these people, and then they do what they do vetting for them. Mimi, I'm nowhere where I do the vetting for them.
Okay, that's all I wanted to know, if the MP was involved in selection or not. You know, I'm a badilisha lugha salasa kwa sababu. We want our questions answered, and this is what we wanted to say when we wanted to talk to the president one on one. Yeah, some hard questions. Yes, can you hear me, Salasia? Yes.
Pipi, I wanted to ask my third question to Salasia was: there's a day he claimed that he gets money from his businesses. I wanted to understand which businesses are so that we as the public cannot be castrating him here online, yet he owns businesses. You can tell us which business is able to give him those millions that they go to donate on church every Sunday.
Have you ever heard me that I'm donating a million? I've never given a million on my side. But now, we have heard about the gentleman who has said, talked about the getting 10 million from the project and whatever. I think what is very more important is, do we have those projects? We must start from the first point. And this is the first thing that we should be asking as Kenyans. You know, we must start then we come in to the other side of the corruption. Mm. Right?
Mm. You have denied all corruption allegations. So, because right now we are not talking to you as the National Assembly. We are talking to you as Honorable Peter Salasia, Member of Parliament, Mumias East. We have asked you a couple of questions and you have been dancing up and down around them. So I'm going to give you 13 minutes of my time. And because 6,000 AO kiongozi ameshaongea, I want to let these other four speakers who are here, because I can't see other speakers on my microphone, ask your question. So I'm going to go with Amerisk. So Peter nakuambiaje. Maswali, ijibiwe direct, ndo to save time. Guys are telling me on the comment section, you are jumping too much on the questions. Unaruka sana. Kama mwalimu, unajua kwamba, kuna maswali ya state, na kuna maswali ya explain. Leo tunajibu explain. Maswali ya state. Yani tunakuuliza, kama vile ukiulizwa, who creates CDF committee? Unanijibu, is MP ama nani? Uvo, unaona? Exactly.
Is your MP.
Aya, sawa.
Tata pia unanisaidia, unajua pia unanisaidia kusaidia. Like,
ni nani kusaidia, MP unanisaidia. Na uko in the future, na kusaidia pia uko in the future, because this is the reason why we have a very bad culture with our leaders. Mkiulizwa maswali, unaanza kuniambia vile ulisaidia wa mama kutengeneza nani. Kufanya kazi pale. Ndiyo tunajua hiyo ni kazi umefanya. But the things that we are asking you, we also need you to ask. Tutana, ame unmute mic yake. Grace, Amerisk are going to ask their questions now. Tutana.
Yes. Nataka kuuliza mheshimiwa, watu wa Bumias East walichagua yeye akiwa maskini. Na wakati aliingia kwa bunge, alifanya nini kusaidia maskini? Kwa sababu vile nimeona kitendo yake kwa parliament, alikuwa amedine with the government that that left the hustlers, the government ambaye walikuwa wana spend more on their own. Yeye mwenyewe alikuwa amejoin serikali kufurahisha watu, na wakati alipiga no ni wakati aliona kwa space ya kwamba kwa Twitter or TikTok ya kwamba Jezi walifanya maandamano, wakati huo sasa ndio amejirecord hata kwa parliament, amejirecord TikTok ati anataka kusnatch the finance bill. So alikuwa na joke with the intelligence of the of the Gen Z, and Gen Z are learned guys. They cannot joke with the minds of the Gen Z. Tunataka kuuliza yeye wakati ameingia huko yeye mwenyewe ameruka maskini. Sai amekataa kujibu maswali aliulizwa payslip yake ni 2000. Hiyo swali yeye alikuwa ameruka throughout. Lakini mimi ile swali yangu amefanyia nini maskini wale wamechagua yeye?
Good question. Number one, I'll just begin by kusema kwamba I've done a lot in my constituency. Nimejaribu kueleza before ya kwamba nimekuja na the various empowerment program in my constituency, kama hiyo kutengeneza mats, wanatengeneza pale CDF.
Ala, are we there guys?
Unasikia uchali? Unasikia uchali?
Kidogo nifikiri nimetolewa bwana. Unajua nyinyi watu pia naona mnanisikiza hapa.
Nataka tu kuambia kindly, we should not give Salasia a chance to sell himself.
Imeisha,
should answer questions.
We want questions, not projects. Ashatuambia projects zote amefanya. Yeah. Ushatuambia projects.
We don't want
sasa unajua huyo ndiye amerudisha nyuma because sasa sisi tunaenda mbele na anarudisha
nyuma. Wewe kama hukusikia tutana. Mimi nimeuliza Salasa question yenye anataka kutujibu amekataa. So nataka mtu mwingine labda amframe otherwise. Grace, ongelesha Salasa in a way that msimuulize projects. Projects you can ask him on another time. I want him to answer the fundamental questions that we are here for. Grace.
Thank you very much for the time. First of all, I am coming from Salasia's area, and it's so bad if Salasia can come here and tell us ati 1 million ni pesa kidogo sana, sisi anatuambia 1 million, and yet your time when alikuwa na campaign literally tulikuwa tunamchangia pesa juu tulikuwa tunajua yeye akienda pale we will get change. That is number one. Alafu I'm so disappointed juu Salasia semi ukweli. Mimi personally, I've worked with county government. And tangu county government kupe kazi, lazimu ulipe 10% of the amount yenye wana offer. Kama kazi ni ya 50 million, ebu eka 10% of 50 million. Na tangu lipwe, I won't mention those county governments, but it is hell. Waki kupatia kazi, wachukue 10%, after taking 10%, tena saza kulipa, wakusumbwe, because the government has huge number of debts awajalipa watu. So, wakati unalipo, unabembelezana ni kama ulikuwa unafanya kazi, ulikuwa unaifanya for free. Ikifika hapo saza kulipwa, tena they want you to pay 20%. Sasa we kama mtu wa biashara, umefanya kazi gani? All I can say, this government is very corrupt. Fuck this government. Fuck this government. Because
now, Ross, I think you have just said that you come from my constituency.
Wait.
I want you to ask me. You said that you come from my constituency, right? And you will changa money for me to be elected.
Yes.
I say yes. Maybe, I don't know. You might be saying the truth or not the truth.
Yes,
now, my question, you should be telling the space here that where have I failed?
You've
but now, mutuambia pia project. Kuna kitu, kuna swali, Salasia huu mrembo anauliza hapa. Umaipewa kickback ya siasa. Umunapewanga kickback. Umaipewa offered. Okay, kwa vile wezi sema utaji-implicate. Have you ever been offered a kickback to give out a tender?
Sasa huyu, huyu kwa sababu amesema natoka kwa my constituency na nilichagua ya kwamba ni mimi nitaleta change. Aniambie ni area gani? Yenye I bila Salasia, the son of the soil. I've never done.
Haya, Grace, sema.
Barabara zote zenye tunatumia ni za former governor. That is number one. Number two, I don't like because personally I see you on TikTok. You brag a lot by expensive alcohol and telling us you are lying to us in our
faces. You are not being objective. You are not being objective. You have just asked. I've just asked you. Like for example, the bursary, you have failed. If you are talking about the roads, which kind of roads are you talking about? It's like now, you carry a lot of malice
but you are not objective. You should tell me like this is the area umeongea mambo ya kickback. Hizo ziko hiyo ndio discussion. Lakini sasa usemi sasa unajua
just allow me to tell you where you have failed. First of all,
yes.
As a voter who even contributed for you, I'm disappointed now when you
say where I failed.
By telling me how you are flaunting on money and you have a lot of it as your voter who voted for you. That is number one. Number two, for you to say that now you've taken women, and personally, I come from that constituency, and I have an NGO running the same program. I have never seen you there. I have never seen you there with women. In fact, women.
Which kind of organization? Now you see, you have never written a letter. You have never told me that you are running an organization. You are just running around
on grants. Just listen. So
you are just bitter.
Gentlemen, ladies, I'm the one who has muted you. I am the co-host. We are going on a back and forth, and please, let's just take turns, please, yeah? We are grown-ups, and we are Kenyans, and Kenya is our business. Let's just take turns. This is not a market, eh? We are trying to get answers, and let's be objective. Pipi, please play the whatever. Watu kunywe maji, watulie. Rudy tuongee to zamana. Play the jingle, Pipi.
Haya, sawa. Can you hear me?
Yo, what's up?
Baby, let's go!
You're listening to Home Run with Pipi. Weekdays from 3 p.m. to 8 p.m.
Ayo. Pole bwana.
Thank you very much.
Nilikuwa na refresh mic. Unanisikia?
Pipi. Nakusikia.
Pipi. Nilikuwa na refresh microphone. Nikajipata nimeenda kwako. I don't know kama the rest can hear me, but I was refreshing my microphone.
Unaweza sikika vizuri.